बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। वेलकम टू लेक्चर नंबर 6 एंड दिस इज़ द लास्ट लेक्चर ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 9, फोर्सेस एंड मशीन्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू क्वेश्चन आंसर्स एंड द क्वेश्चंस आर ऑन पेज नंबर 113। क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, व्हाट डज अ साइंटिस्ट मीन बाय द वर्ड वर्क? आंसर इज, टू अ साइंटिस्ट the word work means what happens when a force moves an object a certain distance in the direction of the force. Question number 2, using a crowbar or some other lever to move a large log is easier than lifting it up with your hands. Does this mean that because of the crowbar or other lever you are doing less work? Explain your answer. Answer is, using a crowbar or some other lever to move a large log is making use of the turning effect of forces to produce a large force. This does not mean that you are doing less work, because work is force multiplied by distance. In this case, you are using a smaller force but moving it over a greater distance. Question number 3 we have done before. Question number 4, what is meant by effort and load when we talk about levers? Answer is, the effort is the force that you are applying to a simple machine such as a lever to move the resting force, which is called as a load. Question number 5, describe some advantages and some disadvantages of each of the 3 types of levers. Answer is, the advantages of a first class lever are that it produces a large force from a small force. The fulcrum is further from the effort than the load. This increases the turning effect of the effort, and the disadvantage is that the effort has to be moved a longer distance than the load moves. A second class lever also produces a large force from a small force. To achieve this, the load is between the fulcrum and the effort. This increases the turning effect of the effort. So, the effort has to be moved a longer distance than the load moves. In a third class lever, the effort is between the fulcrum and the load. This produces a large movement from a small movement. The disadvantage is that a large force is used to move a small load. Question number 6, which class of lever are you using when you chew your food? Illustrate your answer with a diagram. Answer is, when you chew your food, you are using a third class lever. The fulcrum is the 2 points where your lower jawbone pivots at the side of your head. The effort comes from the sides of your jaws. The load is the crushing effect of the jaws that come together to chew your food. Here is the diagram. You can see the fulcrum, effort, and the load. Please try to draw the diagram as well. Question number 7. Which type of lever are you using when you use your arm to lift an object? Illustrate your answer with that diagram. Answer is, when you use your arm to lift an object, you are using a third class lever. The fulcrum is the elbow joint. The effort comes from forearm, and the load is what you are holding. You can see the diagram as well. Next question is, what is the advantage of using a single fixed pulley? Answer is, the advantage of a single fixed pulley is that it can change the direction of a force. It can be used to raise a flag on a flagpole or cloths on a clothesline, and to raise a bucket of sand or cement by pulling down on a rope rather than lifting the heavy bucket straight up. Question number 9, in what ways is the wheel and axle like a lever? Answer is, a wheel and axle is like a first class lever in a way that the fulcrum is the axle and the arms of the lever are the spokes or disc of the wheel. In a wheel, the lever can turn through 360 degrees around the fulcrum or axle rather than the limited up and down or seesaw movements in the usual type of lever. Question number 10. In what ways is the screw like an inclined plane? Answer is, a screw is an inclined plane wrapped around a cylinder. The inclined plane form ridges in a spiral along the cylinder. These ridges are the so-called threads of the screw. Question number 11. In what ways is the wedge like an inclined plane? Answer is, a wedge consists of two inclined planes back to back. When viewed from the side, it has a triangular shape. And the last question is, why do tinsmith's shears have long handles and short blades, while tailor's scissors have short handles and long blades? Answer is, a tinsmith's shears have long handles and short blades because they are used to cut the sheets of metal. In this case, the load is large and the effort has to move a large distance to overcome it. A large force is being produced from a smaller force. A tailor's scissors have short handles and long blades because it's very easy to cut clothes. Only a small effort is needed to move the blades and make a large cut. So that's all for today. Please note all these answers and please learn them. Take care and Allah Hafiz.